Hello students, welcome to a lesson through the virtual training center of the Brihan Mumbai Mahanagarpalika. My name is Shraddha teacher, and in this lockdown period, since we are not able to go to school children, we will be doing many lessons here online through the virtual class. So come on, let's proceed to our lesson for today. So come on children, let's learn a new lesson in standard 10th. Subject is English, and the lesson that we are going to do today is a little different from the lessons that we have been doing all this while. So when we learn English, we either learn a lesson in prose, we learn a lesson in poetry, isn't it? And when we are doing writing skills, that time also we learn to write essays. But most of the writing skill lessons are part of our main lessons, isn't it? When you learn a lesson, there is an exercise after it which asks you to write a letter or which asks you to write certain lines about a topic. But this particular lesson that we are going to do is a lesson entirely based on a writing skill in English. So we will do lesson number 4.5 today. The name of the lesson is The Old Man and the Sea. And this is a book review. So now I told you that this lesson is different, isn't it? So we are not going to read the story of this lesson. We are not going to write the meaning of the difficult words. Okay? We are not going to try and understand what the lines or what the meaning of the paragraphs is. Of course, we will look at the summary of the lesson quickly once. We will try and understand what the story is about. But the point of focus today will be on how to write a review. Now review is of different types. You can write a review about a movie, you can write reviews about plays, about television serials. But when we are talking about writing skill in English, we will today learn to talk about how to write a book review, or we will take a proper look at a book review which is written down for us as part of this lesson. So before we go and see what a book review is, let us talk about certain basic skills in English. So you have the most basic skill, that is the skill of listening. By listening to people, you learn to pick up the sounds of what they are saying, you learn to understand the meaning of the words that they are saying, and then you learn to speak, you learn to produce the language, isn't it? After you learn listening and speaking, which are the basic skills, then you move on to skills which are a little higher level or little higher order, and we learn how to read from a text. After we read, then we learn to produce the language again by writing. So these are the four basic skills in the English language: listening, speaking, reading, and writing. So when you are listening and when you are reading, you are taking in the language. Okay? You are absorbing the language. And when you speak and you write, you are producing the language. So there are certain skills which are called as the input skills and certain skills which are the output skills. So basically, today we will not focus too much on listening, speaking and reading, but we are going to talk about the writing skill in English. So this writing skill is a skill where you produce the language. Like I just told you, when you speak and when you write, you produce the language. You think about all that you have listened to, all that you have read, and you come up with the language. Now, talking about writing skills in a little bit more detail, there are different types of exercises as far as writing skills are concerned. Let us look at some of them here. Okay? So you have essays. Do you remember writing essays? All of us have written essays. from a very, very, you can say, a small class. When we were in the fourth standard onwards, I think we started writing essays. We started producing the language. Okay? At that point of time, you just wrote lines. Write 3 lines about yourself. Write 4 lines about your village. Write 5 lines about your school. So this is how we wrote essays. As we grew bigger, we started writing paragraphs. Alright, so we started writing essays. Then we started writing messages. Now messages have become so common today that you write messages on WhatsApp, you write messages on Messenger, and everywhere you use the language. So here we are not exactly writing, you might be typing, but then it is a kind of a writing skill. We write emails also. We produce the language, we write emails, then we write reports, we write reviews, the one which we are going to talk about today, reviews. Apart from this, think of all the other things that you have written. You have written letters. As we grew up, we learned how to write formal letters, how to write informal letters, isn't it? So there are so many different things that we have learned to write in English throughout our school days. Now, in this particular lesson, we will talk about how to write a review for a book. So we will learn how a book review is written. Now, if you have to learn how a book review is written, you will have to study the review of a particular book as an example, isn't it? That is why in the textbook they have used this particular book in order to teach us or give us an idea of how book reviews are written. So here we have a book called The Old Man and the Sea, and it is a book written by Ernest Hemingway. Okay, so this book, we will discuss the story of this book also in short when we look at the review part. But before that, whenever we start a lesson, children, we do a lot of exercises in the warming up part, and then we go to the main part of the lesson, and finally we touch upon the English workshop part. So let us talk about the warming up part of the lesson now. So let us talk about the person who has written this particular book or this particular novel. His name was Ernest Hemingway. You can see a picture here of Ernest Hemingway. He was a very famous novelist. Now, who's a novelist? A novelist is a person who writes a novel. And now, what is a novel? A novel is a really long story which runs into many pages. So, when you write in English, when you are an author in English, you can write so many different things. You can write short stories, you can write articles. Some of them, they write novels, so we refer to them as novelists. So, Ernest Hemingway was one such novelist. Alright, so we are going to look at his book today, The Old Man and the Sea, and we will see how this book has been reviewed by a particular person. But before going there, let us try and understand what a book review is. So, a book review is a thorough description or critical analysis and evaluation of the quality, meaning, and significance of a book. So whenever you do a book review, what do? The person who reviews the book, of course, he has to read the book first. He has to understand the details, or he has to understand the content of the book in detail, and then he will do an analysis, and he will also evaluate the quality of the book. That is the kind of language used, etc. Then you can also say that the basic purpose of a book review is to help people to decide whether they should read the book or not. Now see, this you must have seen nowadays, whenever there is a movie which comes out. Now of course, due to COVID, for the last 8 months, we do not have any movie being released officially in the theatres. But when there were movies being released in the theatres, you had this kind of movie review on various channels, on YouTube, etc., where people used to look at the movie first, they used to see the movie, and they used to tell you what the good points of the movie is, what the bad points of the movie is, and they used to always tell you whether you should see the movie or not, whether you should spend money to see the movie. They used to rate the movie according to stars. So we give this movie 1.5 stars, we give this movie 3 out of 5 stars. So if a movie gets 5 out of 5 stars, it means that movie is very good. So in the same way, what is the basic purpose of a book review? It is to help the readers to decide whether they should read the book or they should skip the book. They should not spend money on it. Finally, a book review should identify the central idea of the book. It should give the reader some indication of the author's style, approach, and then it should offer an overall evaluation. So it should always tell the reader what the book is about, okay? What kind of story they will get to read in the book, and what kind of, you can say, style the writer has when he writes the book, and what is the plot about, and what is the background setting of the book, whether the book is based on history, whether the book is based on mythology, etc. So all these points should be ideally included in a book review. All right? So now let's quickly see how you should write a review. We are of course going to read the review here, which is given in the textbook. But since we are talking about development of a particular writing skill, in case you're asked to review a book, how will you do it? So let us see how we can review a book. So the first step when you want to review a book will be to give a brief outline of the plot. Plot means the story. Brief outline, okay? We do not want the reader to understand everything about the book from your review and decide ki, oh, now I know what the book is about, so I do not want to read it. Don't do that. Just give a brief outline of the plot. This is a very important point. Do not include the ending. That is the climax. What happens in the end? That is a curiosity factor which keeps the reader glued to the book, which keeps the reader engrossed in the book. Now, in your review, if you tell them what will happen in the end, then nobody will want to read the book. The fun, or you can say the mystery, is lost. So do not include the ending. And this is a very important point to remember when you're writing the review, whether it is for a book or whether it is for a novel or whether it is for a movie. Do not reveal what will happen in the end. Coming to the next point, mention the genre of the book. That is, whether it is a thriller, whether it is a mystery, and whether there is a love story in that book, or whether that book is about history, whether that book is about war. So what is the genre of about? How? What kind of book is it? What kind of a topic is covered in the book? Okay? Then, so whether you will tell the reader whether it is a mythology, whether it is a fact, whether it is a fiction. See, some novels are based on fiction also. Some books are based on fiction also. So this is a very important thing to tell the people, or to tell the reader, what kind of genre the book belongs to. That is, what is the category to which the book belongs to. Then the next point will be, is it the author's first book? If not, then what else has she or he written, and how does this one compare? Sometimes what happens is, if it is the author's first book, then there is a lot of chance for that writer to improve as he goes on writing. Alright, the author can improvise in the next novel that he writes, or in the upcoming novels, or the other novels that he is going to write. So this is also a very important thing that you can mention in your review. That is it the author's first book, or has he written other books as well? Then we come to the next point where we discuss the characters. So the protagonist, who's the protagonist? The hero is the protagonist. The antagonist is the villain. Okay? So you discuss all these things. You tell the people who are the main characters. And are these characters believable? Are they like superheroes who do not exist? or are they believable characters? Now, this again depends on what kind of story it is. If it is a fairy tale, then you will not have characters which are believable. Okay? For example, in Cinderella, you saw that towards the end of the day that Cinderella went in towards the, she went to the ball or she went to the party where a pumpkin became a chariot. And towards the end of the day, the chariot again became a pumpkin. So that is not possible. That will not happen in real life. All right. Then you think whether the book is well written or not. So what do you think? If you read a book, if you think that the book is well written, then you mention that in your review. If you think it is not well written, then you mention that also in your review, but you also have to give your reasons why you feel it is not well written. You can also write whether it is engaging, delightful, inspiring, that is whether it invokes all these feelings in you. Whether you are engaged. Engaged means what? Once you pick up a book, before you finish it, you do not want to put it back. So it is engaging. It keeps you in its grip. Okay? So these are the things you can write in a book review. Then, was it what you expected it to be? So when you're spending so much money to buy a book, did you get the results which you wanted, or were you satisfied with the kind of money you spent on the book? Was it as per your expectation? So that is also one thing which can be part of your book review. And last but not the least, will you recommend it? Okay, now these recommendations are done in various ways. People give stars to recommend a book, or people give adjectives like brilliant, and they say exceptional. So if you recommend it, yes, then why? And if you do not recommend it, you do not want people to read this, you think it is a waste of money, again you can say why. So children, this is one a broad outline of how you write a review for a book. Now you can apply all these points to a movie review, to the review of a play, etc. These are all writing skills. Okay? So the same points you can use if you want to write other reviews as well. So this was about how to write a review. Now we go to some exercises in the warming up part, like I told you. So you have exercise 2, where you're supposed to make a list of famous novels by Ernest Hemingway. And 2 are given to you. So one is A Farewell to Arms, second is For Whom the Bell Tolls. So these are 2 of his books. Let us look at some more of his books. So you have The Torrents of Spring, which he wrote in 1926. Then you have the book called The Sun Also Rises, which he again wrote in 1926. Then you have Winner Take Nothing in 1933. Then he wrote To Have and Have Not in 1937. And Across the River and Into the Trees, he wrote in 1950. And finally, the book that we are going to review today, The Old Man and the Sea, he is written in the year 1952. It was published in the year 1952. So these are some books of famous novels by the same writer, Ernest Hemingway. So when you write the book review for this, you can also write that he has written so many novels before he wrote this particular novel. All right. We have the next exercise here for the warming up part. Ernest Miller Hemingway was a famous American novelist, short story writer, and he was also a journalist. Now a journalist is a person who writes articles for either the newspaper or for magazines. Make a list of other famous American novelists and complete the web, filling the boxes with the names of the famous American novelist. So one name is given to you, Ernest Hemingway. Now there are hundreds of American novelists, but let us write the names of at least 4 of them. So Walt Whitman. Do you remember? You've learnt a poem by the same author or same person this year. So check back. This is an assignment. Turn the pages of your textbook and find out which is the poem by Walt Whitman that you have learnt this year. Then you have Mark Twain. You must have heard about this writer also, Mark Twain. Then we have Herman Melville, and finally Edgar Allan Poe. So I have tried to pick up names which you might have come across in the textbooks when you were learning English this year also and in the lower classes also. So this is the next exercise that we had in the warming up part. So let me give you a small assignment here. So I have given you the names of 4 famous American novelists. You try and add 4 more to this list. Okay. So now we come to the main part of the lesson where we will discuss the characters in the story, the old man and the sea. And we will look at a summary of the story, that is, what is the book about. Then we will quickly look at the review which is given in your book. And then we will go on and we will try and do some exercises from the English workshop part. So, you can see the 2 main characters in the story, the 2 main human characters, you can say, in the story. One of them is Santiago and the other one is Manolin. Now, let us briefly try to understand who these people were. So, Santiago is the old fisherman. So, he is the main character in the story, along with Manolin. Now, who's Manolin? Manolin is a small child who's walking along with me. He is the boy who wants to go to fish with Santiago. So, he wants to go fishing with Santiago. So, you can see here, Santiago with his long fishing rod. And you can see Manolin with a small fishing net. So now he wants to go fishing with Santiago. Now who's Marlin? Now Marlin is nothing but it is a big, strong, huge kind of fish. And finally there are the sharks. Now the sharks here are symbolic characters. They are the ones who try to keep you away from your goal, who try to destroy you basically. So when you are trying to move towards your goal, when you're trying to work hard towards succeeding, these particular sharks, they will try to pull you back. So these are some symbolic characters in the lesson. Now let us look at the story. So this is again there in your textbook. So if you have your textbooks, you can come to page number 175. So just after the picture of the novel, front page of the novel, you have the story. So let us read the story quickly. So we'll be able to understand what the story of the lesson is in short. So there is an old and experienced Cuban fisherman and he has run of terrible bad luck. He has had a run of a terrible bad luck means he is facing some really bad days. He's going through some really bad time and is unable to catch any fish for 84 days. So for almost a period of 3 months, this old man, who is also a fisherman, he has not been able to catch a single fish. His young and devoted apprentice, now who's an apprentice? An apprentice is like a student. Okay? Manolin has been forced by his parents to start working with another fisherman. Now Manolin, of course, he wants to work with his master or with his teacher, but his parents feel that this man is of no use. He is not able to catch a single fish. So he will be a bad influence on our son. A bad example he will set for our son. So they don't want the young Manolin to work with our fisherman. The old man resolves to sail out farther than all the other fishermen and attempt to catch the really big fish. Now this old man is hurt because he is a very experienced fisherman, remember. He is not someone who's just started fishing the previous day. He feels very bad that the parents of Manolin don't trust him with their son. So he decides that I will go farther than all the other fishermen. I'll go far away. Okay, and I will attempt to catch some really big fish from the deep seas. On the 85th day, he succeeds in hooking a marlin. Now I told you, marlin is a very big fish. And if you look here, see how frail our old fisherman Santiago is. So he hooks or he is, you know, able to bait a marlin. But then the marlin is too strong for him. And instead of the fisherman pulling the fish in, the fish starts pulling the boat. Now, the old man and the sea is the story of the old man's struggle with marlin and later his battle against the sharks. So this is a kind of a story which could be inspiring. It has got a little bit of an adventurous element also in it. Alright, so this in short is the story of the old man and the sea. Now, you can say review of this particular story or this particular novel has been done on three grounds by the person who's done the review here. So one is, he's talked about the social and historical context of the story or the novel. He's written about the writing style of the novel, and also he's given his own thoughts. So quickly, let us see the main points as far as what the reviewer has written. So in his review, the first point that the author has written is, or the reviewer has written is, about the social and the historical context of this particular novel. So what is this novel about, or what is the setting of the novel or the background? He says that Hemingway's novel is based on real events, and it also draws heavily on Hemingway's own life. So there are lots of experiences that Hemingway has which has reflected in his novel also. Now, Hemingway also has gone fishing in Cuban waters, and just like the old man, when you read the novel you will come to know the old man is said to be a fan of baseball. Hemingway has also been a big fan of baseball all his life. So this is the social or historical context of this lesson according to the reviewer. He also says that this lesson is based around the World War II. Okay, it was released after the World War II. So he talks about the need to struggle against defeat or death. So in World Wars I and II, the person who was defeated was usually dead. So in this story also, Hemingway talks about how it is necessary to struggle against defeat or death. You can also say that the novel was published in 1952 when people were trying to recover from the mass destruction wrought by the two world wars. And this tale of endurance and ultimate triumph immediately struck a chord with the readers. That is why this book went on to become a great success, because people had just recovered from the Second World War and they were trying to recover from the destruction which had happened because of the World War. And in this story you can see how there is a story of how this person endured and how he struggled, and finally he emerged triumphant. That is why the readers could identify with this. Let's go to the next part here and talk about review point number 2. That is, what is the second point on which the review is based? So it is based on the writing style of Ernest Hemingway. The reviewer says that Hemingway's language is simple and it's pithy. Pithy means it is a language which is full of vigor. It is very active language, or it is language which is very, josh. Alright, so Hemingway's language is simple as well as it fills you with a lot of vigor and energy. So it is not boring, it is not lazy style of writing. He mostly writes in short and straightforward sentences. He writes in short sentences, he uses his words economically and straightforward sentences. But at the same time, the reviewer says that a reader can read his work again and again and find new layers of meaning every time. So every time you read this, you will find something new coming out of it. So that is the beauty of this style of writing that Ernest Hemingway has adopted in this particular novel. Let's look at review point number 3 now. So here he has talked about his own thoughts, that is a reviewer's personal thoughts on the book. Whether he's liked it, whether he's not liked it, what has he liked about the book, etc. So he says, I first read this novel years ago and was left unimpressed. So he's read this novel years ago, the first time he read it, he was not at all happy with the novel. He's written this, he's told you this when he's talked about the writing style also. He says that each time you read it, you will learn something new. He also says that he read the book again and he was extremely moved. Now, why was he moved the next time? Because the strength of the old man was so frail, isn't it? But he was so strong of character. And the kind of devotion that he had. Okay, the kind of, you can say, he said that, no, I will not give up. Alright, the kind of devotion that he had, the kind of desperation that he had, and the kind of readiness that he had to struggle. All these things moved and impressed him a lot when he read the book again. He also says that Hemingway's descriptions of the sea and the creatures of the water is extremely beautiful. He has also said, children, when you read this from the textbook, he has also said that in some way or the other, the struggle of the old man and Marlin, the fish, is almost the same because both are struggling for survival. Both are struggling against destruction. So, children, this was the first video of this particular lesson, book review of the story or of the novel written by Ernest Hemingway, The Old Man and the Sea. Now we have certain exercises in vocabulary and grammar which are remaining. So I will be coming up very soon with the second video for this lesson. So children, wasn't that a wonderful video? And did you enjoy watching it? So if you want to watch more such videos in future, then please like this video and also subscribe to our channel, the MCGM Portal for Education, and also hit the bell button so that you get notified whenever I upload a new video here. Thank you so much for now. Let's meet again soon.